الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا وطبيب نفوسنا وشفيع ذنوبنا أبي القاسم محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد Respected brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We are alhamdulillah in the holy month of Ramadan, and this is the month of Quran. And as we said yesterday, insha'Allah ta'ala, in these sessions we will be focusing on the Quran and tafsir of the holy Quran. One of the programs which we want to do is with the youth, insha'Allah ta'ala, is if time will allow us, we will have a good session with them when we will be looking at tafsir of some of the surahs from Juzu Amma and some for the adults as well. Why? Because we want to make this holy month of Ramadan to be a different compared to the past years. Today, I want to start a series of short surahs in Juzu Amma. Juzu Amma, the 30th Juzu. There are these short surahs, sometimes we read them, but we don't reflect on them. We read them, and sometimes we fail to follow the meanings which are there. And they are so rich with information and things which will help us in our daily lives. So today, we want to start with Surah Al-Fatiha, Surah Al-Hamd. Ma huwa tafsir li hadhihi surah? Ma hiya fadail kira'at Surah Al-Fatiha? Ma hiya ahammul umur allati najiduha fi hadhihi surah? Wa halumma jarra. We want to look at Surah Al-Fatiha to know the meanings of the surah. Of course, we pray in every salah, we recite Surah Al-Fatiha. Every salah, we read Surah Al-Fatiha. What does the deeper meanings of the surah? We want to look at the meanings of this surah. So inshallah, unfortunately today, because of the time, we will not be able to finish. So we will go into first part of the surah, and tomorrow we will discuss inshallah about the rest. So the way I will be looking is, number one, to bring the lessons which we learn from the surah. And I will support whatever I'm going to say in the Arabic tafsir, especially Tafsirul Amthal of Ayatollah Nasir Makarim Shirazi, Tafsir Al-Mizan of Allama Tabatabai, and other tafsir. And when we look at Surah Al-Fatiha, we understand that this surah has got 7 verses, which are known as Sab'un min al-Mathani. So when, number one, we look at Surah Al-Fatiha, we find that Surah Al-Fatiha is known as Al-Fatiha, Fatihatul Kitab, the beginning or the opening. And we will come to discuss about why this particular title. Number two, the surah is known as Sab'un min al-Mathani. It is the surah which has got 7 verses which are repeated frequently. Frequently repeated 7 verses. Also, we know the surah is known as Al-Hamd. Surah Al-Hamd. Now, when we look at the surah, we come to know that the main topic of this surah is Hamd. And hamd is when we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All praise is due to Allah. Alhamdu lillah. So when we talk about hamd, one thing which comes into our mind is that we as human beings, when we talk to one another, if you do something good to me, I can't tell you alhamdulillah. In Arabic language, I say shukran lak, thank you. But for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though I can say shukran lillah, but then I say alhamdulillah. So hamd is when we thank Allah specifically. We don't use this term to anyone else. Also, we understand that this surah, there are many other topics other than hamd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one, when we thank Allah, we find the way of thanking Allah is in this surah. Also, the surah discusses about the mercy of Allah, rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember when we recite Dua Kumail on every Thursday night, we say, Allahumma inni as'aluka bi rahmatika allati wasi'at kulla shay. Allahumma inni as'aluka, O Allah, I ask you, bi rahmatika, through your rahmah, your mercy, allati wasi'at kulla shay, which has encompasses each and everything. So the surah teaches us about how to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, the surah discusses about qiyamah, day of qiyamah, something which unfortunately shaitan keeps us busy until we forget qiyamah. Muslims, some of us, we forget qiyamah. And that's why Imam Amirul Mu'mineen Ali alayhi salam, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad, in one of his sayings, he says, I am surprised. The human beings, how can you forget about qiyamah while every day you see people who are dying? When they die, it means they go somewhere. They will be resurrected. Qiyamah is coming. So the surah, Suratul Fatiha, talks about qiyamah. Maliki yawmiddin. In a different name, yawmuddin. Also, the surah talks about worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we say, Iyaka na'budu, ibadah, has been mentioned in the surah. Also, the help of Allah, wa iyaka nasta'in, isti'ana, la nasta'inu illa billah. So, isti'ana is there. Guidance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the guidance in Surah Al-Fatiha. Ihdina, guide us. So it means if we don't get the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then there is dangerous for us to get astray. And that's why we ask him dua again. Ihdina siratul mustaqim. So keeping us on siratul mustaqim. There are many ways which if we follow, they may not take us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but siratul mustaqim will do that. And then the surah talks about those people whom Allah Azza wa Jalla has blessed them, an'amta alayhim, and those who Allah has shown his anger upon them. Now the question here is, why in Islam, according to the madhab of Ahlul Bayt alayhim wasalam and other schools of thoughts, it is not good for someone to become angry? One companion of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad, went to visit Rasulullah and he said, Awsini ya Rasulullah. The Holy Prophet, give me nasiha. The meaning of the hadith is that the Holy Prophet talked to his companion. He said to him, La taghdab, don't become angry. He said, give me another nasiha. Advise me, ya Rasulullah. He said to him, La taghdab, don't become angry. And three times he said, La taghdab. The story is long. There are many issues which are connected with this. But today we see our families are broken down because of ghadab. When the wife is ghadiba, husband is ghadib, we cause trouble to our families. Houses are broken down, our communities, we can see sometimes we fight against one another because of ghadab, anger. And outside there, road rage. People are shooting one another because why are you overtaking me? Anger management. Anger is not good. But at the same time, we see in Surah Al-Fatiha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ. There is ghadab of Allah upon some people. So can we say that there is positive ghadab and negative ghadab? We are going to discuss about that, inshallah. And then there are people who are astray. Those who gone astray, the surah discusses about that. So, إِذَا نَظَرْنَا إِلَى هَذِهِ السُّورَةِ هِيَ سُورَةٌ مَلِيئَةٌ بِالدُّرُوسِ وَعَلَيْنَا أَن نَهْتَمَّ بِتَفْسِيرَ هَذِهِ السُّورَةِ حَيْثُ نَجِدْ الْمَوَاضِعِ كَثِيرًا مِنْهَا الْحَمْدِ وَالرَّحْمَةِ وَالْقِيَامَةِ وَعِبَادَةِ وَالْإِسْتِعَانَةِ وَالْهِدَايَةِ وَنِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ وَغَضَبُ اللَّهِ وَالضَّلَالِ كُلُّهَا مَذْكُورَ فِي هَذِهِ السُّورَةِ الْمُبَارَكَةِ. So when we look at the surah, we find fadail of Surah Al-Fatiha. Subhanallah. If we were to know the fadail of this surah, when we stand up for prayers, we pray and we read Surah Al-Fatiha, we will wish the salah to be prolonged. Look at, for example, in the book Uyun Akhbar al-Ridha, عن الإمام الرضا صلوات الله وسلامه عليه اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم قال إن الله تبارك وتعالى قال لي يا محمد ولقد آتيناك سبعا من المثاني والقرآن العظيم فأفرد الامتنان علي بفاتحة الكتاب وجعلها بإزاء القرآن العظيم وإن فاتحة الكتاب أشرف ما في كنوز العرش. Imam al-Ridha, the eighth Imam, says, according to the hadith which has been narrated from the Holy Prophet, he says that the merits of this surah, the Holy Prophet says that Allah told me, Ya Muhammad, O Messenger of Allah, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِّنَ الْمَثَانِ. Indeed, we have given you seven frequent repeated verses. سَبْعٌ مِّنَ الْمَثَانِ وَالْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ. And we have given you the noble Qur'an. فَأَفْرَدَ الْإِمْتِنَانُ عَلَيَّ بِفَاتِحَةِ الْكِتَابِ. Allah showed His grace towards the Holy Prophet by giving him Surah Al-Fatiha. وَجَعَلَهَا بِإِزَاءِ الْقُرْآنِ الْكَظِيمِ الْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ. With the Holy Quran, Allah gave Rasulullah Surah Al-Fatiha. And He says, وَأَنَّ فَاتِحَةَ الْكِتَابِ أَشْرَفْ مَا فِي كُنُوزِ الرَّحْمَانِ. If there is anything which is noble under the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is nothing which is noble like Surah Al-Fatiha. It means that it is as if the Holy Prophet says, if you are to look at Surah Al-Fatiha and the Holy Quran, you put the Holy Quran in one side and Surah Al-Fatiha in another side, what Allah has given to the Holy Prophet in terms of Surah Al-Fatiha, it is as if Allah has given Rasulullah Quran, the whole of it, and Fatiha by itself. This is the merit of surah. And we find many other ahadith that according to the Holy Prophet, hadith has been mentioned by Al-Allama Ayatollah Nasir Makarim Shirazi in his Tafsir al-Amthal. He says that, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ ما أنزل الله في التوراة ولا في الإنجيل ولا في الزبور ولا في القرآن مثلها وهي أم الكتاب. According to this hadith, he says that the Holy Prophet says, I swear by the one whose my soul is in his hand. Allah has not revealed in Torah in Torah, wala fil Injil, or in the Bible, wala fil Zabur, or in the Psalm, wala fil Quran, or even in the Holy Quran, surah which can be compared to Suratul Fatiha. Suratul Fatiha azim, as we are going to see inshallah tomorrow, I will mention some of these merits. It says that if there is something which you can recite to bring blessings upon you and upon what is surrounding you, is Suratul Fatiha. According to the hadith, he says, if someone would be reciting Suratul Fatiha upon someone who is dead, Allah, it's easy for him to bring someone from death because of Suratul Fatiha. But now the question is, when we recite Suratul Fatiha, truly speaking, do we see the meanings of Suratul Fatiha the way it is supposed to be? We recite, and sometimes if the imam is prolonging, we say, why this imam prolongs the salah? Yeah, we want Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Malik, Yawmiddin, until Walad Dhalim, Allahu Akbar. And we go on. Suratul Fatiha is everything which we have. If we take it serious, it will change our lives. And can you imagine, يوم القيامة, يعني إذا نحن في المحشر, يأتي ملك من الملائكة ويسألنا, ما هل تعرفون معنى سورة الفاتحة؟ هل قرأتم سورة الفاتحة؟ إذا قلنا نعم. في كل صلاة كنتم تقرؤون سورة الفاتحة؟ نعم. ما معنى سورة الفاتحة؟ أكثرنا لا نعرف. يعني we are playing with ourselves. If every time when we pray, we read Suratul Fatiha from the time of Bulugh up to now, and if it comes into our mind that we don't understand one word in Suratul Fatiha, then we are not taking this Quran seriously. For me as a father, I need to teach my children to know the meanings of Suratul Fatiha. And you too, you need to do so. Why? Because this is the Fatihatul Kitab. It's the opening of the Holy Quran. If we miss to understand Surat al-Fatiha, which is Miftah, how can we be able to know other surahs in the Holy Quran? So inshallah ta'ala, from tomorrow, after this short muqaddimah, we will continue with the meaning of the surah. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the barakah and the blessings of Surat al-Fatiha. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with the meanings of Surat al-Fatiha inshallah. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطاهرين.